I'm going to discuss prostate biopsy and the complications thereof. Many men, depending upon the need for a biopsy, which often include an elevated PSA and or abnormal digital rectal exam, need to undergo a prostate biopsy to rule out prostate cancer. A common question I have of my patients are the complications or risks associated with this procedure. The specific risks include pain, bleeding, and infection. There is the offset risk, although significant, of sepsis, which is an infection that proceeds into the bloodstream, which can require hospitalization, IV antibiotics. The good thing is that this is approximately less than 0.5%. When patients undergo prostate biopsy, we take this all into account, one of which I specifically use a lidocaine injection into the rectal mucosa to numb the area of the anticipated prostate biopsy. The next thing I counsel my patients is to make sure that they are off any blood thinners approximately 7 days prior to procedure. Many of patients are on Coumadin or Plavix, and I have them see their cardiologist to ensure that it's safe to proceed with a biopsy in this setting. Coming off of their anticoagulation. Quite often as well, there's been studies that have shown that patients can undergo prostate biopsy being either on aspirin or Coumadin or Plavix. However, they have an increased risk of bleeding. Bleeding can occur in the urine, stool, and or semen for up to 2 to 4 weeks. The risk of infection can be minimized with the administration of a variety of antibiotic protocols, which range from usually a day before initiation of an antibiotic and continuing this antibiotic either 1 to 2 days afterwards. Most patients tend to recover well from the prostate biopsy itself, and quite often the results are being able to be reviewed within 1 to 2 weeks.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.